Well, I think that it's pretty clear that a lot of government funding is drying up for services that are basically to help people that are the ones that really need the help. And so I think it's kind of amazing that Natalia has taken it upon herself to use her connectivity with LVMH and her profile to raise money and awareness that will go directly to kids in need.
Of course, we're here at the end of London Fashion Week. And what for you were the top highlights this season?
I would say Christopher Kane, Erdem, and Simone Rocha's shows were really great.
Christopher's collection seems to be one that's really caught people's eye. Why for you was it a standout?
I just thought it had a lot of range and diversity within the collection, but he really developed it in a very clear and measured way. So it had like an amazing rhythm between the different pieces. I mean, I saw so many different things, but I think it seems to be like a looser, like haphazard silhouette, like things kind of patched together or quilted together. So.
Of course, fashion's always moving on, but what do you think is unique about London as a fashion capital compared to all of the other shows, you know, New York and Milan?
Well, I think London is really focused on creativity and uniqueness of vision, sometimes to a fault. But I think that everyone who shows in London Fashion Week is really trying to make a big, clear statement, which is more important than the commerciality of the work. Well, actually, I think there was some really interesting casting, like Molly Goddard's show. She casts like regular people. Osman casts like a lot of different artists and women from the art world. And I think that's kind of cool that people are using real women as opposed to just models. I always think that helps you to kind of imagine in a clearer way what the clothes actually would feel like wearing them yourself. So